Hello everyone, I am Shine and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about another shallow foundation, that is mat or raft foundation. Let's demonstrate the definition of mat or raft foundation. Mat or raft foundation is actually a thick concrete slab resting on large area of soil, reinforced with steel, supporting more than one columns or walls and transfers loads from the structure to the soil. A question arises inside our mind that why do we call it mat or raft foundation? We are calling this foundation mat as well as raft. Remember, the word mat or raft is same. There is no independent meaning associated with either mat or raft. They are one. It is called mat or raft because it spreads over the entire area meant for the foundation. It has a very large surface coverage like a mat or raft. It covers all the independent columns over it. A mat or raft foundation can also be referred as inverted slab. Because if we invert a normal slab, then it looks like a raft or mat foundation. Now let's discuss about the characteristics of mat or raft foundation. It covers the entire area of the structure. It is of large size and continuous rectangular or circular slab which carries the load of superstructure and transfers to the area beneath the building. This type of foundation is categorized under shallow foundation. It supports several columns and walls in two or more walls. In case of footing, we excavate only that particular size of bottom area of footing. But in case of mat or raft foundation, we excavate the total area of the foundation. When we choose mat or raft foundation, instead of using isolated or spread footing over individual column, we will use mat or raft foundation. When columns are too close to provide single footing for each, because then individual footings will overlap. When soil has low bearing capacity, but that will have to support high column or wall loads. When there is uneven load distribution. When there is soil subsidence. When soil strata is unpredictable and contain pockets of compressible soil. In case of mining areas with non-homogeneous soil. When structural load is heavy due to storage tanks, silos, heavy industrial equipment, and this heavy load has to be distributed over a large area. When site access is restricted, mobilization of heavy equipment for deep earthwork excavation is not possible. When there is a possibility of differential settlement. Now we will discuss about the working principle of mat or raft foundation. Stress distribution mechanism of mat or raft foundation is very simple. Total weight of the structure and self-weight of the mat is calculated and divided by the total area of the foundation it is covering to calculate the stress on the soil. In case of mat or raft foundation, the contact area of the foundation is much more than any other type of foundation. So the load is distributed over a large area and thus the stress on the soil is lesser and the possibility of shear failure of soil is also reduced. Align the center of gravity of building loads with the vertical line of mat or raft to distribute the pressure evenly on soil. It is not essential to coincide the CG of loads with the centroid of mat or raft by equal loading of column. However, making plan symmetrical will do. Now I will show you some sample or types of raft or mat foundation. The first one is solid slab. Beam slab, flat plate mat, plate thickened under columns, plate with pedestals, piled raft, rigid frame or cellular, Now I will demonstrate you the whole construction process of mat or raft foundation step by step. The first step is to complete soaring around the area we want to build mat or raft foundation. Then we will excavate the soil to the desired depth. When excavation is complete, we will perform sand filling and compaction. We should perform compaction very carefully and uniformly. When compaction is complete, we will lay a plain cement concrete over the ground. After that, it's time to place the rebars, but before rebar placement, we have to place cover block to maintain clear cover. Then we will place the bottom rebar and bottom rebar in another direction. Before top rebar placement, we have to place the chair rebar. When chair rebar placement is complete, we are ready to place the top rebar. Then it's time for vertical column rebar placement. When rebar placement is complete, we are ready for formwork or shutter placement. Now we can pour concrete inside the formwork. After 24 hours or when the concrete will harden, we will remove the formwork and we will perform curing. This is how we construct a mat or raft foundation. So this is all for today, and this is all about mat or raft foundation. If you have any confusion or if you face any trouble, then please comment below, or you may use the email address that I have given to description. Till then, happy learning, keep practicing, see you in the next video.